Bariloche, Argentina, top part of Patagonia, and we are organizing a meeting together with UIAA that has to do with mountaineering and medicine and rescue techniques.
We're here for an international mountain course sponsored by FASA, the Argentinian Federation, ourselves, and the ISSM.
We had the idea to do a course here in South America because we didn't before, and I think it's an interesting region and many interested people to learn. And UIAA has a lot of experience in teaching, and so I thought we should not only travel to South America to hold some meetings, but also to come together with the locals and learn about their way, how they go to the mountains and how they do rescue. And we could show what UIAA does, and we could teach about our ideas how to go to the mountains.
The role of the UIAA Training Commission is to collect good practice from around the world, to compare notes, work as a team to discuss and decide which bits work best in different environments, and then pass that on to other federations, whether they're already established or whether they're developing something completely from scratch.
Well, the course was somehow split in 3 days. The first day was more like theory, means that we wanted to cover all the aspects of high altitude medicine, means acute mountain sickness, high altitude pulmonary edema, frostbite, hypothermia, but also about rescue. And then this led us to the second day, where we wanted to learn and hear how is rescue organized in Argentina. So mainly the three main regions, El Chalten, Bariloche and Aconcagua, let us know how they do the research, the rescue in Argentina. And so the third day will be that we can see how in Bariloche the rescue works really on the mountain, what they do, what they know, and this is very interesting.
The importance of this is it's bringing together many people from South America, which for a long time have not been involved enough in the UIAA. I think it's very important that we do what we can to expand our influence and to bring mountaineers together, both in South America and around the world.
For the Argentina Federation and for UIAA both, this is really important to go ahead with the mountaineering and climbing, and especially to keep in contact between South America and the UIAA itself. One of the days we have the workshops outside. The workshops was a hyperbaric chamber, stretchers, anchors, rescue glaciers, and water treatment.
Today we had the opportunity to organize this practical day, the third day of this course organized by FASA and UIAA. And we had the opportunity to make 3 different sessions exposing our medical commission and the evolution that we had in the last 10 years, which was a very big one. Then we had another session with the DOC commission. So, and the technical commission organized a session where they showed us the ascent techniques and the descent techniques with the stretcher in a technical environment.
El curso me pareció que estuvo buenísimo. Conocimos un montón de gente que sabe un montón y que la verdad que trae un montón de información súper valiosa para nosotros. Y el hecho de poder compartir interculturalmente también.
El curso realmente fue súper provechoso. Hemos podido intercambiar experiencias, opiniones y aprender en múltiples temas relacionados con la montaña.
Então, eu achei o curso muito proveitoso. A gente conseguiu, de uma forma geral, acho que não só eu, mas o restante dos brasileiros que fomos convidados, conseguimos vir para cá. Todas as nossas expectativas foram superadas. Eu achei bem importante, né, a gente conseguir trazer um evento desse porte para a América do Sul. Parece que de uma forma é algo inédito, né? Sempre ficou muito nesse eixo Estados Unidos, Europa. E é importante porque a América do Sul, principalmente onde a gente está, a Argentina, é um eixo importantíssimo para o montanhismo mundial.
Y en Latinoamérica tenemos poco acceso a todo este tipo de cursos, es mucho más frecuente en Europa y en Estados Unidos. Es muy importante para la gente local poder evolucionar, así se puede brindar sistemas mucho más actualizados y con todos los beneficios que esto implica a nivel técnico y a nivel logístico en todos los sistemas que se preparan, en los protocolos, y poder actualizarse es súper importante para Latinoamérica.
I believe that after finishing this training course, there are two main objectives that we have to keep in mind. One is the importance of sharing knowledge and sharing experiences. And the second one is the responsibility that we have to keep on doing these things and to getting people together and have the challenge of spreading out the passion and the conviction that we need to teach and we need to transmit the importance of all this work and volunteering as a concept, because most of the people participating are in some way or other involved in different institutions that have to do with that. So it's our responsibility to keep on doing this.
I think people from abroad will understand our real situation and how we work and what the mountaineering is in this very, very vast country with 4,000 kilometers of mountains, from more than or almost 7,000 to very technical mountains like in the southern part of Argentina. And they will understand what our limitations are as a not a very half developed country, and all the challenges we still have, and what we can learn from people abroad, and people from here getting together makes us from different regions, and that maybe we haven't gone together before. This is a very good situation to get together and start working on national protocols or exchanging experiences and knowledge.
To bring these people together from seven different countries of Latin America, many people from here, from the region, and then our own people from the management board. I think they practically all must have said this is one of the best meetings we ever had in terms of content and form.
There are many ways that federations can get involved with training, either sending people to join our commission so that they can contribute and also learn, but also we arrange inspections. There's a process and they should contact the office, get onto our database, and we can help them towards accreditation. And then instructors who are accredited can, if they wish, if the federation wishes, they can deliver skills certificates as well, which are, you know, have the UIAA approval.
I think it's important that they learn that some of the skills they have are common to other mountaineers, but at the same time we can all learn something. It's also important that we've talked a lot about rescue and how rescue works in South America and the challenges it has, and that we need to find ways to help develop that so it's not so all volunteer based. It's a very hard job for a lot of volunteers. They do a great job, but still it would be better if we could get them better evacuation services and stuff like that. And so that's basically what I've taken away from the conference today.
Well, I think the first thing we already achieved, Argentina is a huge country, and we were able to gather that all the three rescue regions came together. I heard it's the first time in history in Argentina that they really sit together and do speak about the situation, how it is. And I think this goal we already did achieve. And the second thing I think is just learning from each other. That's the most important. And I did see so many really happy people, very enthusiastic in the lectures, but also in the workshops. And I think this is the most important, that we can learn, that we can teach, and that people can go to the mountains and are more safe. Well, I think it was an absolutely successful course. We had very interesting lectures, on a high level. We had a very good insight in the rescue systems here in Argentina, El Chalten, Bariloche, but also Aconcagua. We learned a lot, and I think we had also a lot of possibilities to learn from each other. And I personally think it's a very successful course. We have a lot of happy members and participants. And so I hope really this course gives us also inspiration to do this in other places. Maybe we can go in 1 or 2 years to Africa or somewhere else. And I think also through UIAA in FASA, it was a good time to come together and to have also a few good days together.